All right, joining us now on Hot Copy, we have with us Albay Representative Joey Salceda. Representative Salceda, good morning to you.
Yeah, good morning, Karen.
All right. Now, following recent events, do you still support the People's Initiative?
I support the economic changes in the Constitution. Yes.
All right. But then in the economic changes of the Constitution, do you support that the manner to amend them be a People's Initiative, or what was supposedly agreed upon in the beginning, that it should be a Constituent Assembly?
Trinay na namin yan eh. Nung last year pa na RB86 calling for CONCON, inisnab naman ng Senate.
Oo. Pero hindi CONCON, dapat CONAS.
Di balik tayo, RB82 ni Speaker Lab, ni Velasco, inisnab din nila. There were 358 House bills filed and all of them dead on arrival in the Senate.
So what you're saying is the House has tried CONCON, CONAS, but the Senate has always snubbed it. But would it be different today? I mean, no less than the Senate president at one point after the president intervened and said the Senate will take the lead when it comes to the economic provisions. Didn't you have the support of the Senate then? He even assigned Senator Sonny Angara to study the possible amendments.
Well, they have to get 3/4. So if you look at the political economy or if you look at the political constitution of the Senate, bagsak natin ito, PI. That's the only way to go.
Okay. So let's talk about the People's Initiative, all right? First of all, the People's Initiative, this particular effort, this move, does it plan to abolish the Senate? Because there
are...
But it says there that it's Congress voting as a whole.
Voting jointly, yes.
Voting jointly, doesn't that dilute the independence and the power of the Senate? Why does it have to be voting jointly?
Kaya nga, di sana tinanggalan ng Constitution yung People's Initiative as a process of changing the Constitution. Bakit nilagay-lagay pa yun dun?
No, bakit so, voting jointly?
The framers of the Constitution had in mind, really, the People's Initiative as a way for the people to directly. In fact, that's the highest form of change. That's the highest form of amendment.
Okay, now let's take this one step at a time. So clearly the People's Initiative is a recourse in the Constitution, but we'll get to that later. But why does it have to be voting jointly? Yun lang tanong ko, Representative. Why not
kasi
voting ayaw, separately?
358 times na ho kami kasi nagpropose sa Senate since 1987. Kasi nung right after the... Siyempre, nakita ka agad yung mga mali dun sa Constitution. Obviously, dahil yung na-approve nila, unicameral, biglang bumaliktad sila ng bicameral dun sa panahon ng CONCOM. Alam mo yung CONCOM, it was constituted April. Tapos natapos sila October. Tapos nabutuhan, February. So ang ikli din. Kung ang pinag-uusapan ni consultation, yun talaga, grabe. Ang ikli-ikli talaga. Ito, ilang year, 37 years ang pinag-uusapan. So, ibig sabihin, 358 times pinopost CONCON, CONAS. So, wala naman magagawa na eh.
Okay. But then, is the only way to move the People's Initiative forward, is it really only joining, voting jointly? Is that the only way?
Kasi nilagay din naman doon na pwede one subject matter lang eh.
All right. Okay. But clearly, you know, you won't have the support of the Senate here because it railroads essentially their power and relevance and the numbers because they're only 24.
Edi sana pinagbigyan nila yung CONAS. Pinagbigyan nila sana yung CONCON.
All right.
Alam mo, ang problema ko dyan, let's go to the guts of the issue. Kulelat na tayo sa buong Asia. Ang kalaban natin ngayon, Laos. talo na tayo ng Cambodia, talo na tayo ng Vietnam, lahat, talo na tayo. Dahil sila, bukas tayo sarado. So ano gagawin namin? So it's a moral duty on the part of the House really to push constitutional change on the economic front as far as we can.
All right, so let's talk about this moral duty. I spoke with former Senior Associate Justice Antonio Carpio, and I want to get your thoughts on this. He says that a people's initiative can only amend certain provisions of the Constitution. If it's the fundamental aspects of the Constitution, it will have to be via CONCON or CONAS, such as the form of government, term extensions. Do you agree with that?
That's a very limiting factor. The power of the people, the power of the people, you want to limit that? Gusto kaya nga nagka-EDSA-EDSA tayo, di ba? So, pangalawa, pag binasa mo yung ano, yung pinalabas kahapon na 10650, hindi na pag-uusapan yun. That was January 31, 2020. Nilagay pa dun, who can propose? Anybody. Anybody can propose. So who may commence or initiate the process? Any registered voter or group of registered voters. Mm. So walang pakialam kung yan ay politiko o hindi.
Okay.
So if you read the IRR to the... Alam mo, I was chief of staff of Raul Roco, and this was one of the first, during the first Congress under the EDSA Revolution. Oh. This was the one of the first that he filed. So I know the... Basically... Yan na ano ko kung paano naging defective yung Davide decision. Pero during the Lambino, sabi na wag na natin pakialaman, basta sampu sila, sabi may meron ng batas para dito sa PI. So anapan na lang daw ng butas doon sa ibang mga na hindi na kailangan i-touch yung unang ano resolution. Pero
okay.
I don't think you should restrict the power of the people.
All right, but then Representative Salceda, COMELEC Resolution 106550, which you just quoted, this was issued, promulgated January
2020.
May I read it? So Section 7 says, for the definition of terms, this is via People's Initiative. Constitutional amendment refers to any change in the Constitution that adds, reduces, or deletes without altering the basic principle involved and without affecting the substantial provisions of the Constitution. Revision is not included. So that's the COMELEC resolution coming from the Supreme Court case.
Hindi, 10650 to eh. Pero ang sinasabi ko lang naman, yung pagpapalit. So, ibig sabihin pa talagang kulelat na tayo buong buhay natin. Ito ba yung papamana mong ekonomiya sa mga susunod na generasyon dahil lang dito? Pero sinasabi ko sa iyo, pag binasa mo yung Section 7A, it doesn't completely delete the possibility of changing the manner by which we change the Constitution.
Can you read 7A for me, sir? I mean, clearly you have it in front of you right now.
Yes, here. Okay, Constitution Amendment. Alin gusto mo, letter B?
Yeah, when it comes to the People's Initiative, there's a debate right now that it can't revise the Constitution. It can only amend.
Obvious naman doon nakalagay, refers to any change in constitution that adds, reduces, deletes without altering the basic principles.
All right.
Involved. So ano yung principle? The principle that it can be changed?
No, I think without altering the basic principles. So for example, if we move to parliament,
I totally reject that notion.
Mm. Okay, because when you say principles, the principle of the constitution,
the
when
principle
we move
of changing the constitution, the constitution.
But you, Representative, you read it, it's clear. So the principle will be, for example, if we go parliamentary, that's not the principle of the Constitution.
So wala yan yan, di ba?
So would you agree that a people's initiative cannot change the political foundation of the Constitution, For example,
we are changing here the manner of changing the constitution.
No, for example, do you believe through a people's initiative you can
yes,
change
you
term
cannot.
Limits?
That's why
do you believe
not,
that?
It's not the matter at hand with respect to the people's initiative.
Okay, so
in other words, is it a constitutional principle that constitution must change with the times?
Yes, some people agree, definitely. But I think we're
many
talking.
Many people agree. Na kulelat ng Pilipinas. Na yung lahat ng mga naunahan natin noon, ngayon, lampas na sa atin. Alam mo, Myanmar na lang hindi natin matatalo. Ano ba yun?
Oh, okay. We'll move to that. We'll move to that, Representative. But my question, I think, is with that particular provision that you read, do you believe the People's Initiative can change the political...
The manner of changing the Constitution, yes.
Okay. So even political...
Political ba yun?
Let's say, Representative, listen first. Let's say, may mag-pitch
term... Kanina pa ako nakikinig sa'yo, pero ang gusto mo kasi insist na we're changing the political... We're not changing, we're changing the way we will amend the Constitution.
Okay, so my question is, let's say that if this pushes through, a lawmaker suggests... changing term limits. Do you believe that the People's Initiative can change the term limits that would be covered?
Kasi ito, it is a long route. We go to PI so we can get to CONAS. Because CONAS in CONCON was always rejected 358 times by the Senate.
Oh, so is that a yes or a no? Can the People's Initiative revise?
No, not through PI.
Not through PI. Okay. So clearly you believe it can only in some sections of the economic provisions at this
no.
point.
No. The intent of the PI is to change the manner of changing the Constitution.
All right. Now, moving forward, so you believe in changing the economic provisions of the Constitution, and yes, there is a study that the Philippines is one of the most restrictive in Asia. I interviewed Christian Monsod, and he said, and perhaps you can give your side on this, he said, manufacturing right now can be 100% foreign-owned. He said power can be 100% foreign owned. With mining, it could be if you're partnered with government. He said that right now with the public service amendments, you have telecom and railway that can be already 100% foreign owned. Ano pa ba ang kailangan na baguhin if there are so many industries that can be 100% foreign owned? Representative.
Yes. Unang-una, ano yung konsepto ngayon, competitiveness? Ang konsepto ng competitiveness ay innovation. Nandun yan sa practice of profession. Dati, simula 1902 until 1972, hindi naman yan pinapalitan. Number two, ownership of educational institution. Number three, advertising and media. So yung core ng transfer of knowledge or the origination of knowledge, talaga nawawala. Yun naman talaga ang ano, so tatlo na kagad yun. Ang pangalawa, kung ikaw ay may lupa, tapos hindi naman sa'yo, aayusin mo ba yung paggamit ng lupa? Hindi. Kasi kahit ano ilagay mo doon ng mga technology, hindi naman mapapasayo. Definitely, the basic issue there that needs to be addressed by the people, it's up to us, the rest of the Filipino people, would you allow foreign ownership of land?
Do you want, would you support, do you agree with foreign ownership of land?
Ako, oo. Pero kailangan may limitation. Like indigenous people, hindi pwedeng galawin. There's certain, we can allow them, let's say, for industries and certain other... At Alam mo, yun sa mga binuksan, kaliliit, katulad ng Israel, walang may foreign ownership lands, Netherlands, tapos Australia. Tayo ang number, pangilang ba tayo, number 7 yata tayo, is the biggest owner of foreign owner of land in Australia. But, pero ang laki-laki nila. Pero, for example, for industrial land, they should be allowed to own it.
All right. Now, there are some countries in Asia, like, for example, it's a long-term lease of 99 years. Wouldn't that, some have pitched this, that do you actually need to change the constitution to actually have a long-term lease? They've said right now there's 50 years at this point in the Philippines.
Mangirap na mga si, puro na lang ginagawa natin, tumbling. Ayaw mo ba gusto? Gano'n naman ang tanong ng mga foreign investor. Alam, tagal-tagal ko nagtrabaho sa isang investment bank. Tapos ang unang tinatanong nila, how do you really welcome foreign investments? Tapos gusto mo tumambling ng mga 99, ng mga 50, hindi yun eh. It is your predisposition. Alam mo, pag tinignan mo lahat ng chart, saan simula na naiwan ang Pilipinas? 1987. Kasi hindi naman yan sabihin na natin, perfecto itong constitution natin for ourselves. Pero it's what others are doing that matters. Eh, habang tayo nagsara, sila nagbukas. Ganun lang naman kasimple yun eh.
All right. And you believe that the opening foreign ownership of land will be a game changer when it comes to the economy? I mean, yes. Just to balance the conversation, to be fair, Vietnam does allow foreign ownership of land for all types of property. Just to balance the conversation, right? 100% in most of its sectors, including trading, manufacturing, IT, education.
Pag yung Okta tingnan mo, yung 76% ng concern ng tao, mataas na presyo ng pagkain, kulang sa pagkain. Alam mo, dito na lang sa Pilipinas, 5% ng namamatay dahil sa malnutrition. Sa rest of Asia, 0.3, 0.2. Kasi ibig sabihin, walang kapital na pumapasok sa lupa. Kasi yun na nga, capital hungry ang ating agriculture. Kasi nga, hindi bawal pumasok ang foreigners sa land ownership. So yung mga iba pang mga how do you call that complex ways suggest na ayaw naman natin talaga sila pumasok, kaya wag na lang. So makikita mo yan na yung if we run the numbers, the biggest growth prospects, yung kung yung Senate lang masusunod, ang bubuksan nila 1.98% lang incremental. Samantalang yung sa House, umaabot po ng 12%. Yan po yung existing GDP. But pag tinignan mo yung scope for growth niyan, yung scope for growth niyan, naabot ng mga 32% kung yung sa House. Kung sa Senate, siguro mga 6% lang. So, alin ba ang susundin mo yung nagbibigay ng growth? O hindi. In any case, ang point ang nilalaban natin dito is economic reforms na para makahabol naman tayo kahit papaano.
Okay. All right. And because you are the first representative lawmaker I've spoken to that's been quite open with a foreign ownership of land. Many I've spoken to on Head Start were unsure or vague or actually didn't agree to the foreign ownership of land. But you have been the most progressive with this one. So just for notes purposes, Vietnam allows it, Thailand allows it. Do you believe that this would be the game changer in the economy, foreign ownership of land?
Ano mo, pwede naman, ewan ko kung pwede yung sinasabi na parang time bound. Sige, mag-experiment tayo. Kasi nakalagay naman doon, unless otherwise provided for by law. Na we allow, okay, 10 years, payagan natin.
Make it longer. Let's say you own it 50 years.
Hindi. Yung okay. Opening lang. Yung pumasok within the next 10 years, you can own the land. So makikita natin dyan sa, let's say, hypothetical case na yan. Walang-wala kasing kapital pumapasok sa land. Alam mo ba last year, ilan ang pumasok na kapital sa lupa? 1.2 million.
$1.2 million a people.
Pesos.
Pesos?
Oh, tingnan mo yung BOI. Million. Yes. 1.2 billion ang pumasok
billion. Okay,
na kapital. So, paano maano yung food security? Paano mo maano yung presyo ng ano? Presyo ng mga basic ng ating pong mga ng bigas at lahat. Paano mo masisiguro yung farmer's income? Kasi walang pumapasok na technology. Yung heart and soul of, you know, we have multiplicity of goals. One is food security, supply. Second, which is really price. Third is the farmer's income. Nakito, that is really technology.
All right. So, Representative Salceda, I think I lost you on camera. Are you back? Can we check?
I'm here. All
right. Let me see you on camera again. There you are. Okay. I think you accidentally pressed it a while ago. Okay. So you make a fair argument for the ownership of land. But this isn't popular among your peers. Is this something the speaker supports?
Well, it's in RBH 2, which was approved by the House, sent to the Senate during the time of Speaker Velasco. So basically, may nakalagay naman doon kasi unless otherwise provided for by law eh. So we can put all the other restrictions there.
Mm-mm.
Hindi naman automatic eh. Pero simple lang yan. Kung meron isang bagay na hindi na walang capital ngayon, eh talaga yung lupa, eh yung ati pong average ownership of land. From 3.4, bumagsak ng 1.2 hectares per farmer. So, paano magiging productive yung mga farms natin kung di mo pa lalagyan ng technology, di mo lalagyan ng capital, di mo pa lalagyan ng access to markets?
All right. Now, I wanted to ask you, when the president last visited the United States, apparently that, I think Christian Monsod said there were, I think, $70 billion in pledges. And changing the Constitution was not a condition of any of the investors that actually pledged. In a study that came out, they talked about the investment climate in the Philippines, how the rules change in the middle of the game, the cost of power. So they brought out other issues, but never the Constitution. What are your thoughts on that?
Let's try power and let's try solar power. So, hindi natin magagawa niyan kung hindi natin lalagyan, let's say, ng foreign investors ang ating pong, it uses a lot of land, no? So, we're dependent on local capital for it. Kasi it, kung ililis lang niya, mapapamahal siya. So, you know, these are notional things. So, out of the 70, ilan ba ang na-realize?
Mm-mm.
I don't remember. So, kaya nga, benta ng benta si Presidente across the world pagpunta dito. Eh, hindi naman yan isa lang na factor. Maraming factors, admittedly. Pero bakit mo pa, bakit mo pa na yung isang kamay mo eh nakaipit sa likod mo. Eh di ba pang we-welcome na isang investor, kailangan bukas ka talaga para maging partner siya ng ating ano. So alam mo, pag tinignan mo ang history, during the breakout moment, Singapore and China were growing at 12 to 15%. And we were growing at a remarkable 5 to 7, but it's not enough for a breakout.
Yeah.
So even with FDI pledges, on a party level, we're still receiving the least FDI in ASEAN 6. So even that level is not enough. So yung mga pledges na ganun.
Mm-mm. All right. Now, House leaders have turned down an invitation from the Senate to attend the Senate probe on the alleged signature buying campaign for a people's initiative. Do you believe House leaders should attend?
Ah, decision na po yan nung ano, party leaders. Yung nakita mo doon ng mga ano, parang nasa firing squad.
Sila na yon.
Puro yung mga leaders ng mga political parties. So I think it's already a consensus. Pero maganda sana para mapag-usapan yung 10650.
Uh-oh.
Kasi sinasabi doon, anyone can propose. Hindi na nila pwede kami tawagin politician initiative. Tapos ang sinasabi dito na hindi lang pwedeng gamitin ay public funds to support people's initiative. So at saka ma-clarify talaga kasi I would rather ano talk about 10650 before the Senate.
Mm-mm.
Because it was precisely parang pinuton hold ng ano. Pero tingnan mo ha, January 31, 2020 nila kasagsagan po yun ng Federalism Amendment.
Mm-mm.
So this 10650 was propitiously issued by the COMELEC as the IRR
of the shift to federalism
of 6745 conveniently for a possible of federalism. So I don't know, but I don't want to be very how do you call that tawag niya Machiavellian about these things. Pero para sa akin, simple lang eh. Kulela tayo, ito ba yung gusto natin?
Okay, two more questions, Representative. The COMELEC has issued a statement asking all of their offices nationwide to stop accepting the signature sheets from the People's Initiative campaign. Do you see this as a step backward in effect? Does this prove to be a challenge in the efforts?
Challenge yan kasi yung signaling, pangalawa. So kailangan ma-explica, may explain ulit sa mga tao na hindi naman pinagbabawal kumuha ng signature. So ang kaso yung mga timelines mo, siyempre mag-move yun. At pero hindi ang binagbabawal lang naman na tumanggap ng mga signature. Ang sabi ng Senado, pati sila tumitingin na 43 ang hindi pa nagsusubmit. Pero marami doon, tatlo sa Masbate, tatlo sa Kamsur. Pero, well, it can work both ways. Gives us more time. Pero kasi wala naman time limit o hindi naman naka-time stamp yung ano eh. Mm. Yung pagmirma mo doon eh.
Okay.
Pero
I would
consider that as
a problem. A step backward.
A step backward.
Yes. Yeah. All right. Now, Representative, very quickly, would you be able to guarantee that the Speaker and House leaders have no interest in changing the political provisions in the Constitution? Issues on term limits, yung tinatawag na only term. Could you guarantee that the interest of the lower house is really only the economic provisions?
Gusto ko yung talagang paninindigan ko. I will vote no if that's the case.
Mm-mm. You will vote no for any political changes to the Constitution.
Yes.
All right. Okay. Now, on that note, just very quickly, the People's Initiative has caused this campaign for charter change has caused such a division. So right now, you have the president and the former president throwing tirades at each other. Former president calling the present president a drug addict. Marcos Jr. saying it must be the fentanyl. We've gone down to this very low discussion when the country has so many other economic issues to deal with. But this political divide has scared a lot of people that instead of going forward, we are moving backward. What are your thoughts on the breakdown of the UNI team?
Dadaan tayo dyan. you know Philippine politics. Mamaya makita mo pag magkakatabi na naman yung mga yan. So, wala namang ano dito sa politika ng Pilipinas. Kasi wala namang political party, puro political personalities. You would expect that from a political economy such as ours where there is no well-established political party standing for either socialist or either for free marketeers. So, it must be understood in that way. So, dahil wala naman mga prinsipyo talaga yung mga partido, so you would expect that.
On that note, I want to thank you, as always, for joining me, Representative Joey Salceda. It's always such a pleasure to speak with you, sir.
Thank you.